Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Today would have been great on its own, but, you know, following 2 days of pretty lousy, rainy, cold weather, it was even better. Tomorrow's going to be kind of in between before some more wet weather gets here for the weekend. Here are the details for overnight. Your News 8 Storm Team Forecast, mostly clear and cool. Low temperatures ranging in the upper 30s to the mid 40s. And a change in wind direction to add to the northeast. And then in the morning, that'll be due east. Skies will be partly sunny. Temperatures will be slower to climb tomorrow. And then we'll get up into the upper 50s to near 60 degrees in the afternoon with increasing clouds. So it won't be as warm as it was today. Winds will be at the southeast at 5 to 15 miles per hour. And temperatures outside right now are basically, not too bad. Not exactly in a free fall or anything like that. We've got a wide range depending on how much cloud cover you have. York, for instance, the airport at Thomasville, 47, but still 61 in the capital. 56 in Lancaster, 59 degrees in Coatesville, about 59 degrees also in Chambersburg. Officially coming in at 61 at Harrisburg International Airport. Pretty dry air out there. The relative humidity is only 44%, and winds are already at the northeast at about 7 miles per hour with some rising barometric pressure, high pressure building in across New England, changing our wind direction. We managed to get up to 69 degrees today, 7 degrees above the average for this time of the year. Again, a big change compared to the past 2 days. 44 was the morning low, no rainfall today, but we got just over 0.9 inches between Tuesday and on Wednesday. And basically what's going on right now is a little weak cold front coming in from the north and the northeast, being shoved down by high pressure moving over eastern Canada, heading towards New England. So that's where the northeasterly flow is coming from. We had a mostly westerly flow today as we were being dominated by high pressure to our south. That change in wind direction coming in off the ocean is all the difference we need. So even though we'll have some sunshine tomorrow, without that westerly component to the atmosphere, we won't be able to get as warm as we did today. And so the wind arrows tell the tale. Easterly flow setting up here in our predictor all the way through tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening. There's the increasing cloud cover. Very strong storm system in the nation's midsection right now. The center of that is heading towards the Great Lakes. So we're not going to get in on that. But what we will get in and on are these bands of rain that are heading our way. They move in late Friday night, early Saturday morning, and they're going to be slow to move because they're mostly going from the south to the north, not moving very quickly from the west to the east. So here we are Saturday morning, the light rain and drizzle starting to move in, and then the heavier rain bands move in the afternoon and the evening. So it still looks like the second half of Saturday is the real washout stuff, and it continues into Saturday night. There may even be a rumble of thunder because this will be a fairly strong front going through. That shifts off to the east by the time Sunday rolls around, and that's the one thing it's trending now in the various models is that the system may be even faster. So we may salvage part of Sunday after this shower come to an end. But again, temperature-wise, with an easterly flow this time of the year, we only get up into the upper 50s near 60 degrees tomorrow afternoon, down into the lower 40s Saturday morning, and we're in the lower 50s for most of the day on Saturday because we won't have much sunshine and we'll have that wet weather. So near 60 tomorrow, cooler than today, windy and rainy for Saturday, especially in the afternoon and the evening. And then it just kind of tapers off to showers late Saturday night, early Sunday morning. Some peaks of sunshine late Sunday, back up to near 60 degrees, mid-60s on Monday, upper 60s on Tuesday. And then we probably have another chance for some storms by the time we get to this time next week. So, again, not near 70 degrees tomorrow.
It's been not too bad. Typical spring so far.
We've had a lot of ups and downs.
Yeah, that's what it's all about.